Attrition reminds me of something. That's another big issue, right? Getting the right people, and also not just getting them, but keeping them with you. Abhishek, what's been your experience with building the right team, and what do you think is better for an entrepreneur in terms of retaining the best talent? How has your experience been?
See, the best talent is always built when you build the team yourself. So it's never like...
It's not readily available out there.
Because every business is different. You know, I think everyone on the panel will agree. All of them are different. It may be in the same industry. It may be offering the same services. But there is a different DNA in every business which makes it survive. Because different businesses have to have those different elements which basically makes them stand out and be that different by which a particular client will choose him and not the other company. To create that, you obviously need to build your team from scratch. So don't think that you will just get 20 top managers from different companies.
Ready-made material.
Yeah, and you poach 5 people from this company and 2 people from this company because you have got a fantastic funding from someone. It doesn't work. You know, those businesses, those things go for a toss. And when you create that whole team from scratch, you basically impart your personal values into that. See, you are the business because it was your passion that started the business. It was your thought that started the business. It's your ambition in terms of solving a given problem that started the business. So unless that infection is created to your team, the team is not going to perform in alignment with what you want it to achieve. Mm-hmm. And that is why you need to create the team. You know, I have tried both. Initially when I started off, I created my own team absolutely from scratch. Mm. Handheld, taught them each and every step what to do and how to do. What does Indesit stand for? What happens if a problem occurs with a given client? And that is one experience. Secondly, we also saw when we started hiring a lot of laterals, you know, we started saying, okay, no, we need a lot of laterals who have to come from outside.
Okay.
At the end of the day, you know, my heart again goes out to the same thing that you got to create your team from scratch.
From
it's
inside.
Not going to, it's the laterals you can get to get some lateral talent which is not readily available or some external knowledge which is required in a company. Mm. But it should start from scratch and it has to have your DNA infused into them. If you cannot infuse your DNA, that is the biggest challenge. And when your company grows, you have to make sure that the next level is capable of infusing the DNA further. If the next level cannot infuse the DNA further, you will have a lame organization. And that will create a major problem the moment you grow up.
Okay. And this startups always have another one of those conundrums, dilemmas is, should I engage experienced people or should I take in freshers, raw talent, right? Because on the one hand, they don't have the money to pay senior talent, but at the same time, they also need the expertise at some point of time. Freshers, the challenge becomes that how do you train them? Are they trainable? Yeah. So how do you, if I throw up these questions, what emerges on the balance?
I think a little bit of experience is always good, but honestly, experience is overrated. I think it will be music to ears of everyone sitting in this room because experience is highly overrated, especially today. Because you see, the thing changes every year. So what was there 3 years back is absolutely obsolete today. So what do I do with that guy or what does that guy bring on the table who has got 10 years of experience? A lot of time they have actually nothing that they can really...
So even that guy has to be on the treadmill all the time. So learning...
Yeah, so right? as a professional, when you go out in the industry, you have to be on the treadmill all the time. If you want to be in IT industry, by the way.
Yeah.
If you want to be in some other industry, I don't know about it. I can't comment on it. But if you want to be in IT industry,
Highly dynamic. Have
to keep running. If you are not running, get out of the treadmill, get off the industry. You can't survive in this industry. So experience is overrated because you are as good as the next guy who is joining the industry 1 year back because he knows exactly the same thing that you know about the technology which is in demand today. So are you keeping yourself ahead of him? Now the challenge for you remains is that guy who is coming fresh, he has got time to study. He has got time to develop his expertise. But you are already in a job. How do you develop your expertise while you are running on the treadmill? So that is the challenge that you all have to think about it and you have to execute it. And trust me, the best training programs of the biggest companies will not help you. So don't think that if you have got a job in TCS or Wipro or Infosys of the world, they will take care of your training needs. They can't. They're absolutely incompetent in handling that training that you need to even survive in this industry 5 years from now.
All right, that was quite emphatic. Huh. So let's talk of fundraising for a bit, because that again is a big problem for people who start up, especially in the initial stages. And I'm talking about very, very early stage, people who are starting from scratch. What, in your opinion, Shirish, are the best sources to tap here in terms of support? Now, you had your dad who provided you with a lot of support and gave you the initial impetus. Does that work? Do you think that will work in most cases? Do you think that's a good source to tap into, your family? What are the other best sources?
The best source is definitely your family. But if you ask me, first you should, before asking your family, you should actually go down to the market, try to do something small yourself. Try to do something. Get a small job, start a small part-time business. When I talk business, maybe just maybe some kinds of consulting. Maybe you are a faculty somewhere. Maybe you are training students in the evening. You are going, you have become a private tutor. Maybe you are writing content on the internet. Maybe do something small to earn your own money. When it is your own money, then the risk that you take with that to start your own business, that is easy. But if it is your dad's money, you think twice before spending. So definitely first, you should tap into your own personal finances by putting your personal effort. And after that is done, then definitely you should go to your family. They are the two sources which I suggest if you start initially. Normally what we think, we always plan of thinking very big.
Right.
Even if we are trying to get a job, on the first day we need a job which is going to pay me 50,000 rupees a month. If I am getting a job of 10,000 rupees a month, I'll not even start. I'll prefer to stay in my dad's hotel and get fed by his salary. Right? The same thing as an entrepreneur. You always want to start a big company. On the first day, you want to become Infosys. Why? Infosys did not become Infosys on the first day. You definitely have to start small somewhere. So instead of not starting at all, please start small. If you start small, even Dhirubhai Ambani started small. He was there in a petrol pump.
Yes.
We see Mukesh Ambani and Anil Ambani today. But why don't we go back and see Dhirubhai Ambani working in a petrol pump? That is where you should start. That is where you learn your skills. How to talk to people. How to talk to clients. How to gain clients. What are the problems you face? Learn that, earn money from there.
And get some life exposure also.
Life exposure also. Because it is not just about money when you are starting your business.
Right.
Funding is secondary. First, it comes about experience, your attitude. If your attitude is positive, you will win all the race. If your attitude is negative, whatever kind of knowledge you might have, it will fail today or tomorrow, for sure. That is what my take is.
So you made an interesting point, which is about setting time aside and working that bit extra in order to save money right. as your startup capital, right? Extremely well taken point. Bimalda, what's your take on this? On family, friends, you know, the three F's. And about what Shirish said.
Okay. In fact, I completely agree with Shirish that to start with, first of all, you don't need to become an entrepreneur today as soon as you pass out from the college. It is not late to become an entrepreneur. In fact, I would encourage people to work for at least 2 to 3 years so that you know how corporate works, how different divisions work, how team works, how do you motivate people. So you get a good team experience. And you keep looking for the ideas. As I said, you must have a good observation power. And you, when you decide to jump, you must have the sustaining power for at least a year. Because there are two reasons for that. Number one, when you start, you've got a concept, but it is not tested. So nobody is going to give you money easily at that stage. And number two, even if you are able to get that money, the stake that they will take will be too high because it's a very big risk money. See, if you need 10 lakh rupees at that stage, now you don't have anything to show because you just started thinking about the product. So it's a big risk the investor is taking. So he's going to take a very, very big pound of flesh from you. So you don't want to do that at that stage.
And because of that, the pressure on you is actually going to go up.
Absolutely.
You're going to feel choked from that day on.
You're going to feel choked. You're going to interfere in your business. You will not get that freedom. So it is better that, okay, maybe you have another partner to start as an entrepreneur. Infosys had 7 partners the way they started. So you can always join up with your friends who you share the same wavelength and the aspirations. So 1 year you sustain. After that, personally, I feel that taking money from banks, loan is a much better option than equity capital at the early stage. Because, you see, the banks will probably charge you 10 to 12% of interest. That's all. They're not going to come and interfere in your decision making. They just want timely payments. And you get the freedom of working. And today there are various government sources, like, you know, in the morning NASCOM also we are talking that finance minister has put up 10,000 crore rupees for the startups, right? And there is so much money with Webull. There are various institutes which are giving you money for the startups. So you can take advantage of that money. So build up your business when you are reasonably, you have tested your concept, you are very happy. Now you want to go to the world campus, or you know, you want to increase your canvas. And that stage, if you really need, then you go to the equity finance so that you can rapidly grow. And you also get tremendous mentorship from these equity investors or angel fund. Like if Abhishek is there on your board, then your success is assured, you know, that kind of thing. So he's going to give you so much of insight from his experience, and you know, he'll hold your hand. So that advantage is of course there.
Okay, now I'm going to throw the...
I just want to...
Sure.
Yeah, so I just want to, you know, say that, yeah, these competitions that we are having, the business plan competitions, while you are in college, participating in these, the accelerator competition, going into an accelerator, all these are available today. And, so these are good starting points.
Networking events are available.
Yeah.
Yes.
So accelerators joining, you know, doing business
competitions,
plan,
yes,
winning
yes.
prizes, these are like... So these are also source of, you know, raising your initial funds, yeah? Later, and then putting people like Abhishek on your board as a mentor, So each accelerator will have mentors. So those are things.
Yes,
get
correct.
Those right expertise, right?
Correct.
So when you are starting off, you're exposed to so many experts on your board.
Right.
So
and right at the beginning, you get the right guidance, right direction.
Yes.
Okay. So I'm going to throw the session open to the floor, but before that, I'm going to ask each of the panelists here for just one or two things that you would want to tell an aspiring entrepreneur, a youngster out there, because it's being webcast also. So what is it that you would want them to keep in mind when it comes to taking the plunge? Just one or two things. You will start with Yotul.
So for me, so I've done a couple of products and I've focused on a couple of niche. So one of them didn't work, it failed. So if you do something which is nice to have, it is difficult to work. If you do something which is must have for the customer, it works more easier. The customer would come to you and buy it. So the sale also becomes easier.
It becomes that bit easier for you to build your business.
Yeah, you've got something which is actually, you know, a must have, or which is actually solving a problem, it's easier to sell.
Right. Okay. Bimalda?
For me, it's the passion for excellence, patience. These are the two very important characteristics for me.
So passion and a pursuit of excellence.
Yeah.
Be the best in whatever you
do. Whatever I'm going to do, I'm going to do the best. I'm not going to cut corners.
I'm not going to compromise.
Yes. So whatever service or product, and I must have the patience. That it is not going to happen in a day or a month or a year. It may take years. So you must be prepared for that long journey. And definitely an entrepreneur is one who never quits. See, if you quit, even if you're unsuccessful, you fail. All of us have failed in certain things, right? On the stage also. We didn't get success in our first, you know, thing that we did. But we had the confidence that yes, I have got the passion, I have the patience and people. I will build my team. I will invest in them. I'll train them. You know what Abhishek said, you don't need very experienced people. Of course, you need to have some people to guide your team to, you know, you have to have experience. But then this young team, all of you in the room who are here, I mean, if you're given a proper training, proper motivation, proper guidance, you can excel.
So you're talking about passion, pursuit of excellence, and staying on, perseverance.
Yeah.
Great. Shirishda.
We have already covered whatever suggestion we wanted to give to entrepreneurs. my suggestion will be slightly different. I can see a lot of elders over here who are parents or teachers, I'm not sure, but definitely parent. So my suggestion will be to parents, please support your son or daughter who are wanting to become an entrepreneur. Give them the required support, at least mentally, so that they feel confident about their journey. Because to be very frank, I am here because I got my family support. Without family support, I don't have been here. I've seen several entrepreneurs dying out just because they did not get their family support. Their family taught them, get a good job in Infosys or TCS. If you don't get a good job, you will not get a good girl to get married to. Right? So just for getting married, they are getting a good job. And they are leaving aside their dream. So yes, please, parents, please support your son and daughters. Let them grow, let them have their own wings.
Because if you want to see them being happy, then this is one way you can make that happen.
Yes.
Right. Yes.
Make them happy. Make them grow.
Yes.
Support them if they fall. This is what happened with me, and this is what I want that others should also get. Thank you.
Superb. Abhishek.
Tying up the knots which were going in my mind. One is persistence, which is very critical. So you will fail 5, 6, 7 times, but you cannot just leave it at that. So, I mean, I failed in the first thing I did. I continually failed several times in between when I was running the company, a lot of different things I was trying my hand at. But it's okay. I mean, failing is absolutely okay. It's just, as we say, as we hear those quotes, you know, it's just learning those ways which by which it cannot be done. Second is, a point came up about valuation. I had one very important line to say, value creation is always above valuation. Please think about value creation. How are you creating value for someone who's going to pay you rupee? If someone is giving you 100 rupees, how can you give him 120 rupees back? If you cannot do that, you are not in business. Then you are out of the business. However beautiful and nice it looks like, it doesn't matter. Last but not the least, I think we started with something very interesting about the motivation to be an entrepreneur. I'll just like to make a comment on that. A lot of people said that I want to be an entrepreneur because I want to be my own boss. Trust me, 17 years in business, I don't think I am my own boss. I am not in my own boss. I am bossed by my employees. I am bossed by my clients. I am bossed by my friends.
And your teammates.
Yes. So I am bossed by everyone. So trust me, if you are an employee, the only person who bosses you is your next boss. But if you are a boss, if you are an CEO, if you are an entrepreneur, you are bossed by everyone. And you have to keep everyone happy. That's the only key to survival.
Great. Wonderful. So, guys and girls out there, shoot. You can direct your questions to any particular panel member if you so desire. Otherwise, you can throw up questions in general. Who's going to be first? Are there pen drives on offer for this too? I hope you don't have to offer. Are there mics there? Yes.
Yeah, there's someone at the back.
Someone there. Who's going first?
Hello.
Hello.
First of all, good day, everyone. Thanks, NESCOM, for organizing such a wonderful event. And thanks to the panelists for such a wonderful enlightening discussion. I am Devjyoti Sutradhar from NIT Silchar. And I'm glad to have an angel investor on board. So my question will be directed to him. It's like, suppose all of you have, all of the panelists have the products of different area background. I mean, my question is like, how to grow or build a product outside my own expertise? I mean, I have a product idea in mind. So if I'm going to pitch it to an angel investor or something, then what are the expectations should I have in me or in my team so that I can grow? And if it's in my team, I mean, last three startups I have been failing only because I couldn't build a good team. And my current startup, I am also facing the same problem to get people of my wavelength and to get associated with me. So like, what is the key factor that can stick to make a team grow?
So there are two parts to your question. One is how to pitch to an angel, and the other is how do I keep my team together?
How to pitch an angel investor of a thing that of a product that is not of my domain expertise.
All right. Abhishek, you want to take the first part at least?
The angel part.
Yeah, that's what.
Yeah. So, angel investors won't see your product if you don't have a prototype. Okay. So, they want you to first go through the grind yourself. So, angel investors have become smarter. Right. So, they have become much more smarter than they were. So, they first used to just invest if someone walked up to them and they said, I want 20 lakh rupees because I am trying to create the best CRM software in the world, or I am trying to create the most interesting mobile app in the world. They don't care about it anymore. They want you to show the proof that you can really create that. So first of all, if you want to create a product company, you got to get coding. The biggest challenge is, you know, we think too much and we plan too much before doing anything. I think we need to first take a jump and do something so that the other person get interested and they feel that you are serious. So every angel investor wants to see your seriousness about what you want to do. Unless you can show that, they won't even give you an appointment if they are a serious angel investor, by the way.
All right, got that loud and clear.
And so his other part of the second part was that what if you do not have the expertise and you want to build that product, so you bounce your ideas with so you have the passion for that particular idea, right? And but you do not have expertise, so you bounce your ideas with people who have expertise and seek their expertise.
Why do you need funds to test your product first of all? I mean, today you can simulate your product. To build a prototype doesn't mean that you have to have a physical product. There are so much softwares available to simulate. You can test that product with your target segment by just looking at the products. You can you can do a 3D printing. Suppose, I mean, if it's a product, I'm not talking of a physical product if it is. So you can even make a 3D printing of a product in maybe few thousand rupees, and you can test that product. So we have to get out of this psyche that, as we discussed in the very beginning, that first 1 year you want to do with your funds.
Yep. Okay. Yes. Next, please. Yes, right at the back. I think there's someone standing there.
My name is Inadul Alam. I'm from Jet King. And my question is, what mistakes you did in your career and how you recovered them? That is my question.
All right. Since all of them have been mistakes, who wants to choose to answer this question? What mistakes have you made?
we went on and took all the projects from all customers, whatever came to our way. That was a mistake. The other mistake is we built a product which was a nice to have kind of a product. So these are two mistakes that we made.
Do you want to just expand on the first point, Atul, about, you know, all startups have this problem of running around like headless chicken, at least for some time. Mm-hmm. Where did you find this need to focus on a niche, and why? What is the merit in that?
So. You realize after you get into that mess, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So once you get into a mess, people start leaving you and you do not have that expertise, you're not able to support your customer. So then you realize, no, we cannot do all
you're
that.
You're spreading yourself thin.
Yeah. So you look at 3-4 things that you have done, and things which has got more traction, you follow those projects that you have done well, you repeat it. So every time you do a project, you think that, can it be repeatable, can it be resold? So
and scalable.
Those are ways of, you know, coming to a niche, getting into a niche.
Okay. Yes, someone here in the third or the fourth row.
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay, we heard that. Is it good to go for open source? But do you want to? Do you want to refine that a bit? Open source is a very catch-all term. So. Open source in what sense?
Sir, open source, when we define something open source, we share a code also to the world. So I want to know that, is can we do some business based on open source?
Okay.